ci potrebbe abbiare come c'è una vita. Priti c'è paura, poi non. Avela e amce paura, amce modra di avan apna zai mun, apna si apondra. Amce modra della carta mun, amiduki zera. Punto a sorigin soba, amcamulo corun munta. Cost sostereno, vozan bocterano. Moje singea, autunca samadan curta. Autunca bisotto. Soi amce duca, taci cota e amcamino. Educhi Christi mona, am sosum. Antias barabu, amce bava cati. Atami Bapa Pratim. Pornis vum avarat suritam, caic maraune nazaram. Pornis vum avarat suritam, caic maraune nazaram.
Thank you. to put in the door. the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, and of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, we have got together in this church this afternoon to say fare forward to our brother Avelar Barrett. At funeral masses, I don't like to say we have come to say farewell, like an adieu, goodbye. We come to say fare forward, go ahead, because we are following you one day. So we come to wish him well for the journey that he has already begun into eternal life, and we come to pray for him. We pray also for his beloved wife, Marie Beth, his sisters, Marie Ren, Emma, and other family members, that all of them may have the strength to take this test as an expression of God's will. Let's prepare ourselves to celebrate this Mass worthily by calling to mind our sins and asking pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done,
what I
have failed to do.
Through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy on your people gathered here. Christ, have mercy on your people gathered here. For you know we have sinned.
Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Avelar, whom you have called to journey to you. And since he hoped and believed in you, grant that he may be led to our true homeland to delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the book of Job. The theme of the reading is, I know that my Redeemer lives. Job answered and said, Oh, that my words were written. Oh, that they were inscribed in a book. Oh, that with an iron pen and lead, they were engraved in the rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been thus destroyed, yet in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself. And my eyes shall behold, and not another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, Lord.
At that time, Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask from God, God will give you. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Martha said to him, I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this? She said to him, Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who is coming into the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, events like death distress us. And when such distressful events occur, we have no better way, no other way to face them except through faith. Faith is the only way we can face these distressful events like death. And faith comes through the hearing of the Word of God. We have just heard the Word of God. We should give us faith to face the event of Antonius passing away. We have heard the Word of God in the form of two readings, the first and the second. Both these readings have more or less the same message to us. Let us try to draw this message so that Marivet and all of us may get strength to face this distressful event as Antonius passing away. The first reading is from the book of Job. It is in the form of a story. Job, a wealthy man, very wealthy man, his wife, his many children, plentiful livestock, big fields, big yield, produce, lot of servants under him. He was some kind of a Maharaja of those times. But then, sinister events begin unrolling themselves, one after another. First, his enemies come and take away the livestock. Soon after, other enemies come and steal the produce. of the fields. Soon thereafter, some kind of tsunami takes place. And while all his family, the entire family, his sons, his daughters-in-law, his grandchildren or great-grandchildren, they were gathered in a festive occasion. A tsunami comes and all of them are smashed under the roof which fell. It was distressful events, one after another, to Job. And then, to cap everything, he is afflicted with a sore body. One wound, the whole body putrefied, exhaling foul smell, which not even his wife would bear. Job was a holy man, enters into dialogue with God, or rather God enters into dialogue with him. And at one time, we have got its outburst of faith. I know that my Redeemer lives. I know that in this flesh of mine, I will see God my Savior. His sufferings were abysmal. The deeper were his sufferings, the lofty was the expression of his faith. I know that my Redeemer lives. In this flesh, I shall see God my Redeemer. More or less, we see the same in the second reading, in the story of Martha, Maria, and Lazarus. Jesus was friendly with this family. Whenever he required a better meal or he wanted to rest, he would go with his disciples to this family, and the family would entertain him. And now, the brother of the family, or it may be the head of the family, Lazarus, dies. And Jesus goes to meet them after his death. There is a dialogue between the two sisters. We have heard only the dialogue of Martha, the same more or less of the other sister also. And Jesus tells them, "Your brother shall live. Your brother shall rise again." And Martha and Maria, who were in the midst of a deep sorrow, they express a lofty, they perform a lofty expression of faith. "We know that my brother will live. We know that you are the Son of God, the Christ, the Son of God." The deeper the sorrow, the higher is the expression of faith of Job as well as of these two sisters. And today here, before this death of Antonio Avelar Barret, which has afflicted his widow, who is my neighbor at Salvador do Mundo, and his whole family, there is no other way to face this event except through faith. We know that Antonio will rise again. We know that Jesus is our Redeemer. We know that Jesus will raise him up. We know that Jesus is the Christ. There is no other way. However graceful words we may speak, however tight we may give an embrace, there is no other way that can give consolation to Mary Beth, Antonio's relatives, close and distant, than these words of Job, these words of Martha and Maria. I know that my Redeemer lives. I know that he will raise up Antonio. I know that Jesus is the Redeemer. I know that Jesus is the Son of God. I know that he is the Christ. As I console the bereaved family, Mary Beth to start with, my appeal to them is only this: faith. The deeper is your sorrow, the higher should be your faith. And it is faith and faith alone which will stand you in good stead in the years to come, and especially in these days to go.
We have heard the word of God. We have been reminded that our God is a God of the living, not of the dead. For he who said, I am the life and the resurrection, he is our Redeemer who lives. And we have been reminded that our friend Antonio Abelard Barret had placed his faith on this living God. Let us, in the same faith, continue our celebration. sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy Church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Antonio, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For even though by our own fault we perish, yet by your compassion and your grace, when seized by death according to our sins, we are redeemed through Christ's great victory, and with him called back into life. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. Of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come.
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Philip Neri, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Antonio, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Like most of us gathered here, Antonio was inserted into the great family of God on earth through his baptism. He learned to call God Father. Let us at this moment address ourselves to the same Father, to our God, in the words Jesus, his Son, gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Yeah.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and
my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Antonio may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I've been told, please sit. I've been told that Advocate Zilman would like to address us. Before that, allow me to make a short reflection, and a very secular reflection. I'm not going to talk about God. All of us know that Antonio Avalar Barret was very popular with his friends, also very popular with four-wheelers, especially of a particular family, the Volkswagen, and sub-family, Beatles. We know how, when any of them would face problems or need some kind of cure, his magic hands did the trick. Why did I say this? Because when I was coming to this place, I had to pass his house. And I was moved to see some shining Beatles in front of his house, ready to escort him to this place. When I reached here, there was another new Beatle, which may not have met him, I do not know. But this is all to say that Avalar leaves a lot of saudade among us. He will be remembered not only by his family and friends, but also by his four-wheeler Beatles. May he rest in peace.
Friends, I would fail in my duty if, as a good friend, I have not said these parting words to Antonio, and here I am. It was 10:30 p.m. Being a Sunday, I was relaxing in my room in the serene of the night when a call from a friend disturbed me. This friend broke to me the news of Antonio's demise. I reacted. Death? Why did you sickle away the life of my childhood friend? I murmured. I was in shock and grief when the news came. But I recomposed myself and tried to reach a little further. I prayed for his soul and for the strength of his wife during this difficult time. As I was doing that, a thought came to my mind, which filled me with courage. And the thought was that God knows what he does. And when he did, Jesus thought of taking away Antonio from this world in the right earnest to take him to his kingdom. Antonio was not an active churchgoer, but he was a true Catholic. Therefore, I am sure that God has taken this childhood friend of mine in a good judgment to his kingdom. Antonio was quiet, was kind, upright, helpful, harmless, and a good human being. I am sure everyone here gathered will concur with me in my judgment of him. My association with Antonio dates back from the days of my childhood. We had a common primary retired tutor who happened to stay on the ground floor of my house. Her name was Professora Ashpulketa Saldanha. She was a strict disciplinarian. We both were getting tuition from her.
I visualize today in my mind Antonio as a meek and handsome lad, as he was. I would not say pampered child, but being the only son of his parents, was showered with a lot of attention from them. We both used to play marbles on the open space of my compound. Antonio's passion at that time was cars. At the age of 6 or 7, he learned to drive his father's car. His father had a Volkswagen, coffee in color, I think the first, as he used to tell us, sold in Goa. And he not only learned to drive that car, but he was keen in learning the machine of the car and how to repair it from his own skill. His passion was, in fact, the Volkswagen car. His grandfather, too, had a Volkswagen. If I remember well, it was an olive green color, which he was proud of, and he would drive with his grandfather's driver by his side and me as a back-sitter. Antonio had a difficult adolescent life. When he was about 9 years of age, I remember when both of us were studying in Lyceum. I was in the second year and Antonio had just got into Lyceum. We were shocked to learn that Dr. Avalar Barreto died in the operation theater room due to an explosion in one of the oxygen cylinders of the OT at Ribandar Hospital while preparing a patient for an operation. My memory is still live to the fact that when Antonio, who was in the classroom, was asked by his sister to come with them and proceed home, that was when his mother and his sister broke to him the news. Antonio, from that day, had to think of a life without the guidance of his father. His mother, Donna Olga, Irene and Emma, his two sisters, had to guide his life to ultimately grow him into a perfect man and a genius in his own field. During college days, his love for cars and innovation did not die. After completing his college education, much against the will of his family, Antonio decided that his professional life will be something connected with the automobile industry. His passion and love was Volkswagen cars, and his achievement was to one day sell or deal with Volkswagen cars and or design car for Volkswagen, which he have achieved and was successful. Soon after completion of his college, Antonio ventured into buying old cars and remodeling them. He built up a collection of Volkswagen cars and remodeled some of them, and for that he set up a small workshop in his compound. From his own enterprise, he started remodeling and reshaping cars, if I'm not wrong, a design for one of the camping vans, which is submitted to the parent Volkswagen company, was accepted and used by the company for designing a camping car. For his passion and love for the brand Volkswagen, Antonio was rewarded with the Skoda dealership for Goa. Skoda is a Volkswagen subsidiary company. It was then that Antonio successfully launched himself into the business of automobile industry. He set up a full-fledged showroom and a service station at Giring as Avalar Motors, where he constituted a company with his wife Yvette as a shareholder and successfully handled the dealership until, due to his age constraints and market conditions, decided to say enough is enough and surrendered the dealership, though he continued with his self-acquired engineering skill with a state-of-art workshop at Giring. Antonio was a true friend, and I say so from my own experience. We were 4 close friends from childhood, with friendship continued till date. I may name the other 2 friends, namely Dr. Zé Felipe Monteiro, who lives in Portugal, and Armand Ribeiro, and the 3rd one, Aurubin Furtado, who is not amongst us and who Antonio is perhaps going to meet soon. Antonio and I, being almost neighbors, continued being friends till date. Antonio had good organizing skills. He was instrumental in setting up in Goa a prestigious organizations like the WIA, various car rallies, all India and international. The reputation which Antonio built, not only amongst friends, but generally in the social circle and trade circles all throughout Goa, was that of a harmless human being, upright man, and would never harm or hurt anybody. And that was the goodwill he had generated, which made him popular and known not only in Goa, but in many parts of the country as well. The void Antonio that has left is irreparable to his wife Yvette, and who has been his companion in life, and to his family, namely his sister, Dr. Emma, Dr. Irene, and Dr. Ruiz. All I can say is, Avalar, as you were lovingly known, you have left us today, but you will be remembered forever for your good deeds and achievements in the field which you targeted as a Goan icon. Your talent and your dedication and love for Goa will always be remembered by us. Goodbye, Antonio. Thank you.
Please stand. We shall now have the final commendation and the farewell. With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother to be buried in his human imperfections. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful judgment, forgive all his sins. May Christ the Good Shepherd lead him safely home to be at peace with God our Father, and may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the Eternal King. Saints of God, come to his aid, come to meet him, angels of the Lord. Your response will be, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Please repeat.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you to take you to himself, may angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Give him eternal rest, and may your light shine upon him forever.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Father, into your hands we commend our brother. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life, to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Christ Jesus. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our brother to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. We shall now, after you pay your respects to the body, can proceed to the cemetery.
You,
laughed and cried. I've had my fill, my share of losing. And now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that. And may I say, not in a shy way, then he has not to say the things he truly feels.
आतांचो आमी मिसाचे भेटेन आमच्या भावा पासत आमी मागला जाल्यार आतां ह्या फोंडा सरशी आमी देवाच्या उपकाराचो सुरू करूया. आमच्या भावाक ह्या जिवितांतलो आपणाच चडशी देवान आपयलो. देखून मातयेची केल्ली ताची कूड आमी मातयेक लायता, पूण मेल्ल्यांतलो प्रथम जिवन जालो जेजू आमची विनाशी कूड आपले कुडी सारकी हो विनाशी करतलो. देखून आमच्या भावाक सोम्याचे आदीन करूया. सोमी आपले शांतीन ताका भेंगो आनी निमाण्या दिसा ताची कूड पुनर्जीवन. आमच्या भावा पासत आमच्या सोम्या जेजू क्रिस्ता लागीं आमी प्रार्थूया. ताणें म्हणलें, हांव पुनर्जीवन कोण आनी जिवीत, म्हाका सत मानता तो मरत जाल्यारूय जियेतलो, आनी म्हजे थंय जियेता आनी म्हाका सत मानता तो सासनाक मरचो ना. थोडी मागणी आमी देवाच्या पांयां लागीं दवरुया. आमचो जबाब जावं दी, तुजे लागीं प्रार्थना आयक आमकां म्हणुया. लाजराच्या फोंडार तूं रोडलो सुमी आमची दुखां पुसून काड. तुवें मेल्ल्यांक जिवंत केलें, आमच्या भावाक सासनाचें जिवीत दी. आपले पाप रडलोल्या चोराक तुवें स्वर्ग भासयलो. आमच्या भावाक तुज्या राज्यांत घे. आमच्या भावाक पवित्र स्नाना पोरवीं नितळ केलो आनी पवित्र तेलान ताचेर मोर मारली. तुज्या भाग्यवंताच्या जोम्यान ताका एकठांय. आमच्या भावाक तुज्या कुडी रक्ताच्या पवित्र जेवणांत बसलो, ताका तुज्या स्वर्गीच्या जेवणांत बसय. आमच्या भावाच्या मरणा वरवीं आमी दुखेस्त जाल्या. भावार्थाचे बुजवणेन आनी सासनीक जिविताच्या बोरवाशान आमकां धीर दी. थोडो वेळ ओगीच रावया आनी आमच्या भावा पासत मागूया. सगळी मागणी एक करून जेजू शिकयल्या प्रार्थना म्हणूया. आमच्या बाबा स्वर्गीच्या, तुजें नांव पवित्र जावं, तुजें राज आमकां येवं, तुजी कशी सरकार जाता तशी संवसारांत जावं. आमचो दिसपट्टो गिरास आयज आमकां दी आनी आमी आमचे चुकलेल्यांक बक्षिता. तूं तशें आमची पात्रां बोस आनी आमकां ताळणें करून दिवंक नाका, पूण वायटांतली आमकां निबार. सर्वेस बरा आमी तुजे लागीं प्रार्थना. तुज्या मेल्ल्या चाकराची काकूत कर, आपल्या कोरण्याची शिक्षा ताका दिवं नाका, कित्याक तुजी कशी पाळूंक मोह नासलें. बऱ्या भावार्थान हांगा ताका भावार्थेंत एकवट आयलो, तेच परी तुजे काकुतीन स्वर्गी देवदूताच्या बोरान ताका स्वागत मेळूं. क्रिस्त आमच्या सुम्या भोरवीं सासनाचो विसव सर्वेस्परा ताका लाभय आनी निरंतरी प्रकाश ताचेर पांपय. जिविताच्या जिविता तुजेच जिवीत म्हाका लागो. उजवाडाच्या उजवाडा तुजोच उजवाड म्हाका दाखो. भाट सूर्याच्या सांगा त्या तूं बाबा सोरशी म्हाका पावो. जिविताच्या जिवीत तुजेच जिवीत म्हाका लाभो. उजवाडाच्या उजवाडा तुजोच उजवाड म्हाका दाखो. पाट सूर्याच्या सांगाव्या तूं बाबा सोरशी म्हाका पावो. Top of Parish Priest, Father Walter Lisa, and Sister Father Christian Fernandez, on my behalf, to thank them.
तेरे उतना मैं हार का हूँ एक नीचे उतना हार का ऊपर आए लंबा हुआ तो
Because heaven's now your home, I've fought the fight. I've finished the race throughout the trial. No longer do I suffer. My body's been made whole. I'm flying with.
Thank you.